Right, we're going to tie another samurai today. This one is the black banana samurai. So we have a 3.2mm outer and a 1.8 inner. I'm just going to join the two together. Now, what I'm going to do is take a little diamond shape of adhesive lead foil and set that on up here under where the thicker part of the body is going to be, and wrap that on. Now, for the butt on this fly, I'm going to use Mirage Opal, which looks really well over a black tube. So I just tie in a little bit of that. Put on two or three wraps, should be enough. Tie in, fold back, tie over. Next portion is a holographic gold flat rate. I'm going to take that forward maybe 2/3 or so the length of our tube. Tie over, fold back, and tie in. Next, I want to make a dubbin ball out of like a light bright or Angelina type fibre. This one is a gold colour. And you want this to be kind of straggly, so don't worry about how neat it goes on. Now, you've got like a golden olive. This is fin raccoon or tanuki. Take a bunch of that. Tie that in and bind it down. Take a strand of crystal hair here and lay it on roughly the length of our wing. It's doubled over, and we'll double it back on itself. If you want less flash, you can put in two strands, no strands, whatever you want. Next, I'm going to take a portion of black tanuki. This is going to be the top part of our wing. Proportions ways of banana colour to black is up to yourself. Some people will want a predominantly black fly and some a bit more of the lighter colour. The idea here is this will be slightly longer than our previous one. Get that bound down as well. Now, just take our brush the two to each other, and that should create a nice tapered wing for us. So, I'm going to put a couple of strands of peacock over the top of that. I'll break a few off. Bit of a curve into them and set them slightly on at an angle, and then as you tie them in, roll them onto the top of your wing. So now we want to add a couple jungle cock. We'll take a pair of jungle cock, hold them at length in the tip, and strip them to the same point each, and set that up onto our fly. Sort of on the sides almost, They're probably sitting up. At 10 and 2 o'clock, if you're, imagine your fly is a clock. Just double the ends of those back. Next, I'm going to take an olive or golden olive sort of. Light bright color, and make another dubbin ball in front of our wing. And you can pick that out if you want, but what I like to do is to take another bunch, hold them through your hands to align them, cut them in the middle. And then set that bunch on and bind it around its middle, making a false hackle or ruff. I'm going to put on a turn of a golden olive, kind of a soft hackle. Down, folding the hackle over to double it, nip out the tip, pull a couple of fibers forward, and apply that. Now, at this point, I'm not looking to travel too much with my thread. I'm looking. Because I'm going to be putting on quite a flat comb. So I'm going to take a little run of glue on my thread there. And just wrap that back into itself. I'm going to use a cock pheasant rump feather, which has been dyed black. So I'm going to strip that down, grab the tip, bend the feather, and double that over. Tip and fold it over on itself. And then we'll wrap that on, but we need it to be very tightly wrapped onto the front there. To finish this fly, we're going to put on a little gold hybrid cone or UFO disc kind of a thing. So we need to just get the head of the fly dabbed with glue to accept that. Push that on and ram it back into it. Fly off, hold it vertically, bore the inner tube and hold that in place. And there you have a black banana samurai.